Good evening, everyone, and welcome to our Teachers Edition. We're now in the third quarter of our study of the Bible. Our topic throughout the quarter is making friends for God, the joy of sharing in God's mission. The author of our study guide is Dr. Marvin Lee. He used to be the Vice President of the General Conference in charge of evangelism. He's now a retired minister still serving the church in his private capacity. May I invite you to bow your heads as we start. Our Father in Heaven, tonight we thank you that we can review the whole week's lesson that would give us the motivations to witness that they may also be saved in your kingdom. I pray in Jesus' name, amen. Let me give you the major theme of this whole quarter's study. It runs throughout the scripture, the plan of redemption. I'd like to begin in the red box. The problem of man is actually sin. Romans chapter 3 verse 23 tells us, "For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God." Romans 6:23, "For the wages of sin is death." This problem of man is truly a problem, is a dilemma, is a predicament that he himself cannot save. He needs somebody greater than man or greater than him. A man, a person, or a being that has no sin. And so there is only one to solve his predicament, his dilemma. And that is none other than the Creator himself. And we are told that as soon as there was the plan of creation, there was also the plan of redemption. And the Redeemer is none other than the Creator himself, Jesus Christ. So in AD 31, Jesus has given his life on the cross as a substitute. Instead of you, instead of me to be crucified, it was Jesus Christ. So the death of Christ at the cross, his blood that was shed on the cross has provided salvation for all. So you see, the problem of man, and that is sin, has been solved by Jesus Christ at the cross. Now salvation is available for all. But this salvation, according to the plans and design of God, must be brought to all people using a mediation. And that mediation is none other than you and I as witnesses of the love of God. That is his template. That is his design, that salvation be brought by fellow human being. God can save man in other ways, but he sees that witnessing is the best and perfect method because the witnesses themselves are actually changed and developed and prepared for the coming kingdom of God. Their characters are polished. So that is the divine masterpiece of preparing his people. He saved his people, and then the salvation they received, they share it with others. So we have there Acts 1:8, "And ye shall be witnesses unto me in Jerusalem, in Judea, and to the uttermost part of the world." So this is the general concept. This is the major theme all throughout the quarter study. So our major topic this quarter is focused on the mediation variable, none other than witnessing. And Dr. Mark Finley is the right man to share this one because this is his expertise. He retired as an evangelist of the church, global church. So let's begin our study, which is actually a question. Why witness? This topic actually provides us the motivations, the reasons for witnessing. Our memory text is found in 1 Timothy chapter 2 verses 3 and 4 from the New King James Version. "For this is good and acceptable in the sight of our God and Savior, who desires all men to be saved and to come to the knowledge of the truth." So God, our Savior, desires all men, that includes women, children, girls, and boys, to be saved and to come to the knowledge of the truth. That is actually the doctrine of predestination in the writings of Paul. God predetermined all to be saved because He loves them. He loves people. But not all will be saved because salvation is a choice. His people who have been saved should bring this salvation to all people as their witnesses. And the people must respond either for life or for death. And so we answer right away the question, why witness? According to our author, we witness because witnessing provides opportunity for salvation. Number two, we witness because witnessing brings joy to God's heart. And number three, witnessing develops our character. prayer. And number four, witnessing is an obedience to Christ's command. And number five, witnessing is a loving response to share. These are the subtopics of this week's study. I now provide you details on each of these, and then after discussing the theory, the principles, I will spend the rest of my time processing. Number one, it provides opportunities for salvation. So what are those opportunities, methods that Jesus provides so that all may have the perfect opportunity to be saved? Number one, according to a study guide, is that the Holy Spirit moves upon the hearts of every person. So you have there Philippians chapter 2 verse 13. It says as it is God who actually moves us to will and to do. So our desire to be saved is the promptings of the Holy Spirit, and He works upon each person. The second opportunity God provides for all to be saved is the glories of nature. Nature speaks of God. It's a general revelation where design is clear, there is that symmetry, regularity in nature. All this speak of a divine designer. Number three, opportunities for salvation that God provides, the acts of providences. The circumstances in life has been designed by the Lord such that every person may know Jesus Christ. So ordinary things in life actually are God's way to bring salvation to them. So if you are invited to a seminar, if you are invited to attend church services, these are providences of God. If you happen to watch videos on religious services, that is God's providence that you may be saved. And the fourth one, the ministries of Christ is the most perfect opportunities for salvation. His ministries actually are three. The first ministry of Christ was His substitutionary death at the cross. And that has provided us salvation from sin only by grace through faith. In AD 31, He ascended up to heaven and He became our priest. He mediates between us and God. That is His second ministry. The third ministry of Christ is judgment. 1844, Jesus has started His last ministry, and that is judgment. When He finishes, He would come to take His people. Number two reason or motivation for witnessing is because witnessing brings joy to God's heart. And our author has provided us illustration based from the Bible. The first one is the parable of the lost sheep. The shepherd takes care of 100 sheep, and then at the end of the day, he counted the sheep. There was one that was missing, and the shepherd has left it to his fellow shepherd. He went out to find the lost sheep. The shepherd carried in his arms the lost sheep. The story ended in rejoicing. So there is joy in the heart of God, and all the angels rejoice with God when one sinner repents. Another illustration is used about the lost coin. That coin was very important, a dowry of the woman, very important to her life. And she made all her effort to find the coin. And when the coin was found, again there was rejoicing. She invited the neighbors and celebrate because the lost was found. Another one was the lost son. And the son left with all the properties that he inherited. And when he came to his senses, he returned to his father. While he was still very far, the father ran to meet him, and he ordered his men to prepare for the celebration. So this concept illustrates joy to God's heart when one sinner repents and turns to God. What is your part in bringing joy to God's heart? Number three, witnessing develops our character is by giving anything we have, material or immaterial, we share it or we give it to others. I'm using here a concept that is called cognitive behavior concept. The first there on top, it says there, the thoughts create feelings. So when we study the Bible, all these biblical thoughts and concepts, when we study the Bible, it touches our feelings. And of course, the touch there actually is created by the Holy Spirit. So when we study the Word of God, when we hear God's Word, or when we read it personally, it touches our feelings. especially when you study the acts of God without sin, He offered His body there, it would touch our feelings. And that feelings, based on this cognitive behavior theory, it will create behavior. It will compel a person to act and share the thoughts, the concept, the good news. And behavior reinforces the thoughts. So it's a cycle. Once we receive God's word, it touches our feelings, it compels us to do it again and share it with others. Allow me to read these two passages. John 7:37-38. If anyone first, let him come to me and drink. Whoever believes in me, out of his heart flow rivers of living water. So when we receive any information, any messages from God, it will actually motivate us to share it with others. And the sharing it with others actually enhances or develops in us the joy of sharing with others. And that becomes our habit, that becomes our character. Luke 6:38. Give and it will be given to you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over, will be put into your lap. For with the measure you use, it will be measured back to you. So when we share whatever we have, concepts, good news, properties or things, we share it with others, actually the first beneficiary is ourselves. The joy is different from the joy of those who receive what we have shared. And this is what God wants to develop in us. This is the reason why He channeled salvation to us, because this work will develop in us character, just like the character of Jesus Christ. Number 4, obedience to Christ's command. This is actually the command of Christ, and we are very familiar to this great commission. Go and preach the gospel to all people. So you see there, the command is to go and to preach, and then the target group of the preaching of sharing the gospel is actually all nations, because God loves the world. For so the Lord has commanded us, saying, I have made you a light for the Gentiles, that you may bring salvation to the ends of the earth. Acts 13:47. In Isaiah 49:6, I will make you as a light for the nations, that my salvation may reach to the end of the earth. You see, God's longing is for all people to be saved. They are His children, created in the image of God. And the last reason for witnessing is because witnessing is a loving response to share. I conceptualize the love of God like a triangle. Inside the triangle is the love of God. And there are three angles. The first one is God. His love toward me, His love toward others, and my love towards others. So I and you are loved by God as well as others. This triangle cannot be complete without others. His love for others are the same with His love for you. So in 2 Corinthians 5:14, it says, for the love of Christ controls us, or constraineth us in King James, because we have concluded this, that one has died for all, therefore all have died. This is a loving response to Christ. It is love that moves us, as Paul did it. You see, there are things we do because of love, and there are no difficult things if it is motivated by love. And only acts of love will be registered in heaven. Only acts of love that will be accepted by Christ. God loves His people who will respond lovingly. Let me go now to the reflection in which I will see to it that all my Sabbath school members will respond to this. Number 1, based from the reasons for witnessing or motivation for witnessing, I translated into a personal statement, and then I would scale them, and it is in the scale that I would help the person come up with the best behaviors so that they will do it next week or this week. Number 1, I tell others about Christ's ministries. His ministries on the cross is the first ministry. His ministry in heaven as a priest, whenever we make sin or commit sin, He mediates, and that Christ is doing His judgment work. I tell others about
about that.
Do you strongly agree with this, or do you agree, or you are undecided, or you disagree, or strongly disagree? If my Sabbath school member would say, I am undecided, then I would help the person. What brought you to number three? And I will explore that. If he has some doubts in the ministry of Christ, I will give more information about that. If he needs more Bible study on the ministries of Christ, his death, his priesthood, and his judgment, then that is the time I will share with him. If his answer is undecided, and then I will ask him one or two behaviors, what he will do to increase his level of understanding about the ministries of Christ. And that would be time consuming. And number two, I bring joy to God's heart. Strongly agree or strongly disagree, undecided, agree, and strongly disagree. If my Sabbath school member would say, I agree, level 4, or I congratulate the person because that is very high level of agreement. In other words, he is doing many things to make God happy. I will unpack that. I will ask, what brought you to level 4? What specific behaviors do you do that you think God is happy for you? So I will unpack that. What do you do to fellow men? Oh, maybe he would say, you know, every Saturday I would cook food and share it in the community. Or every Saturday or Sunday, I gather all my used clothing and then give it to the children and to the poor. Or every Sunday, I set aside certain amount of money and wrap and buy some things and share it to others. And so on and so on. And then I will ask, what else will you do to make it strongly agree? Or maybe he would say, this time, I want to learn how to give Bible study. I will be personally conducting the Bible study. I praise the Lord for that. And I would be willing to help him, to equip him how to give Bible study. Okay? And then, number three, I develop my character by giving. This is an area where we need to really spend time. How is his character developed? What is the impact of sharing properties or things with other people? I will unpack that. Okay, if he says agree, what do you do? What, share with us experiences in which your character have been changed, developed because of sharing. And what else would you do to reach a higher level? That's it. And number four, I obey Christ's command to preach. Level 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And the last is, I love God, that's why I share. If I say I strongly agree, I will unpack the answers. What are the specific behaviors that would demonstrate that I love God? These are the areas where I have translated the concepts, the lessons that we have learned into specific behavior, personalized, so that he will do it this day and the following week and until Jesus Christ comes. I hope you learn from it. This will be how I will teach this coming Saturday. Let's bow our heads for prayer. Father in heaven, we thank you for this opportunity of reviewing the basic reasons or motivations for witnessing. Help us that each one may be able to internalize it, that we may be prepared for your kingdom. I pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Lift up the trumpet and loud.